Hello, it's Kat, and in today's video, we'll be taking a look at the Radial Repeat feature in Adobe Illustrator to create some snowflake artwork. I'm starting out with an RGB document. My artboard is 1080 by 1080 pixels, and I've got three layers here. The sky is in the background. My top layer has some guides and a grain effect, and I'll be drawing on the middle layer that says flakes. So what I'm going to do for my first line, grab my line tool here, and holding down shift, I'm just gonna draw a short straight line right here. Now, I wanna be able to see my snowflake live as I'm drawing it, so I'm going to apply the radial repeat before I start adding any actual artwork. So we'll go here to the object menu, down to repeat, radial, and now you can see that it has created this radial repeat using our artwork, and by default, you'll get 8 repeats. You can adjust this either up here in your control bar where it says repeats by using the arrows, or you can do this manually with one of the widgets here on the sides. Down will decrease your instances and up will increase. There is also a widget at the top here that adjusts the size and rotation of your radial repeat. And if you don't want your repeat to go all the way around your circle, you can adjust that by using these two buttons at the bottom with the arrows. Now I'm going to use my properties panel and just make sure this is centered to my artboard. Okay, so I want 6 repeats, so I'll adjust that, and I want my size to start about here. Now the trick with radial repeats is to actually get in and edit the artwork and be able to see your edits as you're making them. You'll want to double click on your original piece of art, and now you'll be in isolation mode, which you may be familiar with from working with groups and other things in Illustrator. If you need to get back out of this mode, you can always do that by hitting escape or by clicking this back arrow twice to get back to your regular view. So I want to be in that radial repeat view to edit it. So I'll go ahead and double click back in. And now here's the fun part. If I grab my pencil tool again and start drawing any sort of shape, you'll see that it's repeating live and I can go ahead and make any sort of design that I like here. You can also use your shape tools or your pen tool just the way you would creating any other sort of artwork. And you can come up with some pretty neat designs this way. So I'm going to just delete these little squiggles and we'll start making a snowflake design. I also want to note that once you're in here, if you don't even want to use the art that you started with, you can delete that. And if I go ahead and make something new, you can see that the radial repeat still works. So I'll start with this diamond shape and I'm going to line that up with my guides. And I'll just start manipulating the shape the way I would with any other sort of artwork. I want to do a nice cutout shape with this. So I've just duplicated the shape by using Control or Command C and Control or Command F to paste that back in front. And popping open my pathfinder, I'm just going to do a minus front. That gives us a nice little snowflake. Now let's say I want to add some detail using one of my drawing tools. So I'll grab my curvature tool here and just click to add some lines. One of the things you can do to make drawing a bit easier is to lock your artwork as you are drawing. You can see the curvature tool here, if I grab it, is kind of notorious for wanting to complete other lines or add points instead of drawing a new line. I'm just gonna hit escape, get out of that. And I'll come over here to my layers panel and I'm just going to lock every path that I've already drawn, including my snowflake shapes. And now if I use my tool, I can draw a new line and we can just add a few details. And then if I want to make any changes to those, I can just go ahead and unlock and use my tools as normal. And I really like the diamond shapes for this, so I think I'm going to make another square in the center here and just adjust its rotation. I find the process with snowflakes to be very experimental, so I don't actually have a sketch or anything like that for this design. And I'm just going to try a few things and see what I like. And the beauty of this is that I can see all of my changes in real time, so I have a very good idea of what the final design will look like as I'm working. I found that when doing experimental designs like this, it's really helpful for me to save a few copies as I'm working, just in case I have a design like this that I really like, but I want to keep iterating on it and have the option to go back here. You can use the history panel, which is fairly new to Illustrator, and there's a button down here at the bottom. If you click that, it's going to create a new document with your artwork in its current state, and that basically just saves a new copy if you go ahead and save this and give it a name so that you can always go back to this state of your document. And then you can continue working with your artwork, and it doesn't matter how many history states you have if you run out of room there. Now you can always get back to that version no matter how many changes you make. And just a shortcut to get out of isolation mode if you want to preview your artwork in its regular full color view, you can double click anywhere outside the artboard and that'll get you back here. So I'll go ahead and leave a link to the documentation on the radial repeats in the description below. And I'll be making a few more of these snowflake designs in preparation for a snow brush set that I'm going to be releasing next month. I hope this was helpful. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any questions. I'm always happy to help. As always, happy illustrating and have a great day.